All right, let's get to the paper review now. Lots and lots of stories, interesting stories, making the headlines of our papers recently, and today is no exception. It's really interesting. It's time for the paper review now. We have in the studio Dr. Dan Ekere, a senior lecturer from the University of Lagos. It's good to have you join us now.
Thank you.
Thanks for joining us. All right, so let's begin with a punch. Zimbabwean military places Mugabe under house arrest. Finance minister also detained in takeover. Nigeria, Britain, South Africa. Others call for calm. And of course, a story there, Robert Mugabe and his luxury-loving family.
Very interesting indeed. I think that will be the best thing that, for me, the best thing that has happened to Zimbabwe in recent times.
It's not a coup,
call it any name, whether coup or whatever. This is one coup that is important. Yes, if you call it a coup, yeah. Because what Mugabe needs to quit that office is a coup of this kind. Whether palace coup, whether garage coup, or whatever you call it. I think Mugabe has overstayed in that office. He needs to see somebody else on that seat. He should, ordinarily, he should be somebody that people will run to for counseling, for advice, and what have you. But he has chosen to be the demon that is tormenting Zimbabwe.
And unfortunately, you know, from hero to villain, a man that used to be on the same pedestal as Nelson Mandela.
The military has done well.
Found himself in this situation.
Well, a lot of people will disagree with you as far as, because when democracy is concerned, any act of the military is certainly not welcome in democracy.
Yeah, you see, that is the problem I have with people and democracy. Democracy is not God-given. It's a human activity, all right? And every other thing, the same way. Now, when democracy is unable to deliver, all right? If democracy has led to the kind of system where one man who is elected now eventually becomes a king, because Mugabe is no longer a president, he's a king of Zimbabwe.
Yes.
And for him to turn to His Royal Majesty, I think the people want a better life. And so far, he has not delivered that much. Because if at the end of the day, Zimbabwe is enjoying, you know, quality life, nobody will bother about who
which
is on
he really
seat.
Did provide Zimbabwe initially. I mean, from
but he has bread exhausted basket, all his
from
knowledge.
The bread basket of Africa to a basket case.
That's that was at the beginning. You see, there's a level you get to that diminishing returns begin to set in.
Exactly.
That is what has happened.
And it has set in. Okay, now this one is a very troubling one. Babasala down with a stroke, cries for help. I wonder how many young Nigerians are familiar with that name, Moses Olaiya.
Very, very correct. In fact, even some, the ones you call senior people might not even know his true name other than Babasala.
Babasala, that is what we used to watch. He's very popular.
But I think he's one veteran that should be given special attention.
And he's crying out now that he should be helped now, rather than wait until he's dead and then we start praising him and start talking about
eulogizing.
All the great
that is,
things
that is
he
the
did
problem
when he was
with
alive.
Nigeria. We like celebrating just the dead and those who are living. Sometimes I even frustrated to the point that they have to die before we appreciate them. I think Babasala needs some attention, not just from the entertainment world. I think Nigerians generally should give him some support.
It's okay. All right, let's move to the Nation newspaper now. We have the bold headline there says, ex-governor, Southwest rejects PDP's plan for chair. There's this disquiet over decision to throw a race for chairman open. Now, there has still been this controversy as to whether there should be a unanimous candidate and
consensus
should come from a consensus candidate or it should be thrown open where everyone can go there to contest.
I think consensus would have favored PDP the more, really.
But anytime it comes to
consensus
there is
equally,
always
it's not something that you don't impose it. You call it consensus. It means that everybody
should
agree. Now, unfortunately, they've not been able to agree on, who should be the particular person that will lead them.
In fact, the zone that should
produce
the chairman.
Even the question of zoning, ordinarily, the question of presidency, they said they want to take it to the north. And by that implication, the chairmanship should come to the south. But you see Ayo Fayoshe contesting for...
But he's saying... Ayo Fayoshe is saying...
I know he's trying to make a show.
He's saying his ambition does not disturb anybody's ambition.
That is the way it comes. When Trump was contesting, his ambition never disturbed anybody. But he became president eventually.
All right, there's also a headline here. The Ojukwu's son defects to APC as Buhari campaigns for Nwoye. Now, we know that the Ojukwu family has been or had been in Abga all the while. So I wonder how this the trends are changing here.
Well, that is
and what it will mean for the election in 2020.
That's the beauty of politics. Mm. Ojukwu and his son, they don't have the same mind, they don't have the same brain. All right? Mm. Ojukwu has lived his life, he has made his mark. Mm. Now, chances are that the son might not make his mark on that platform. Mm. So he has a choice to go to wherever. But I think at the end of the day, he should not do anything that will bring down that name, that image. In terms of leadership, let it not be the type that could be bought over so easily. All right, he should show a sign that truly he was brought into this world by that veteran, that that you know, heavyweight called Ojukwu,
and that he's standing on principles not just, and not
an ideology.
He should stand on such solid principles.
Yeah. It's okay.
Okay, moving on to the Daily Sun. Chibok parents write Buhari, say 20 of them now dead. That's 20 of the parents waiting for their children to be returned, of course, from 276. How many do we have freed now? And we still have so many of them in captivity, in Boko Haram's captivity, and not much seems to be.
Well, that is a very sad one. But you know, if we go by antecedents, chances are that another batch will be released by either May 29 or before May 29 in 2018, because the release has always been something close to, you know, the so-called Democracy Day. You know. So it's unfortunate those 20 parents have to die without seeing. Maybe theirs would have been among the ones that will be released later, because negotiation has always dovetailed into, you know, the release just a few, you know, weeks or thereabout before Democracy Day, perhaps as a way of celebrating Democracy
Day. Well, Christmas is around the corner. Let's hope, you know, the rest of the girls will be released.
They will certainly
Christmas.
Be released.
That will make great Christmas present for not only the parents, but for Nigerians as a whole. 20 billion naira, dollars, $20 billion missing in NNPC, Falano alleges.
But I don't know, how did he come about the allegation? Is he working with NNPC now, or was he a whistleblowing?
But you remember when
Falano should know.
No,
he's
more or less blowing the whistle. He should blow the whistle properly. So that he can get his own percentage.
But with this one, now that.
But he should mention those who are involved in it. So
yeah, but you remember when Sanusi, Lamido Sanusi, when he was former, the Emir of Kano, when he was former governor of the Central Bank.
The same.
Exactly.
Yeah, but the challenge was Sanusi's own was that the figure kept changing from moment to moment. Yeah. I don't know if Falano's own will take the same trend, where it will reduce from 20 to...
Well, it says it's been missing since 1999 till date. What else do we have here? Okay, well, police restore Obianor's security as Buhari, APC governors storm Anambra, Ohaneze warns IPOB and troublemakers. Okay, he had to take Buhari's presence in... Anambra to get Obianor security details back?
Yeah, so I think that's a good one, that the security details have been restated. It was a big shame that the IG has to act the manner in which he acted, removing the sitting governor's security details as a result of election. So I was just wondering whether in 2019...
Yeah, he didn't want any of his men to jeopardize...
That is why I'm wondering whether the same thing will be done in 2019 to President Buhari. Would they remove his security details just because they don't want his men to do...
If he's going to contest?
No, chances are that he's going to. They have already pushed him into the race. His mind and body are already in the race. Yes, it's just that his mouth has not said it.
Until he says it.
We don't need to, because Buhari has always ruled by body language, according to people. So I don't think we need to hear him first.
Okay. All right, we have, let's move to the Vanguard newspaper now. Federal government revokes Intel's expatriate permits, and five other firms affected. Immigration gives them till November 30th. To quit Nigeria and Interior Ministry to deport them after month end. We know the Intel has been having a running battle with the NPA all the while.
Yeah.
I wonder when we'll see the end of this.
I don't really know the details what the challenge is, but there seem to be some measure of bad blood there from the speculations.
Yeah.
And
if
the company has not, you know, run foul of the law, I don't see why all this brouhaha should be there, but I expect that due diligence should be, you know, followed in doing whatever we do, so that at least you are calling for foreign direct investment. You should create an enabling environment that will give them confidence that truly where you invest your money, you can reap.
I don't want to take actions that will send the wrong signals.
Yes, exactly. Now, before the Mr. and Mrs. section that you are going to take, we see the vice president. Professor Yemi Oshibajo looking down, assessing the Mile 2 of Apapa Expressway, the gridlock there. I think the government has been moving to see what they can do as far as that is concerned. Now, the federal government, Lagos government moved to tackle Apapa traffic gridlock. I wonder...
In fact, that is a challenge that is long overdue. Apapa is a gateway to the nation's economy, in a way. When it comes to shipping, well, everything that has to do with maritime business, Apapa is one. And the only way you can bring those things out of the port is through those roads we are talking about. Now, the roads are so terrible. In fact, I'm wondering how business, you know, men and women are able to carry on with it. I hate going to Apapa as a result
Everybody
of this.
Everybody hates
going to Apapa.
I don't like going there for anything.
Mm.
Because once you are on that road, the day is gone.
Absolutely.
So we need to, and time is money.
More troubling is the fact that the other end of this same road that leads you all the way to Cotonou, Aflao, to Côte d'Ivoire,
the same,
all 10 lanes.
Honestly,
and
honestly,
you know, but as soon as you get to this, the Nigeria side of it,
things change completely.
And then Apapa looks like this. Well, Oshiba just looking like a good pilot here. All right, Mr. and Mrs., finally, madam. Okay, who is complaining here now? Most times, women drive their husbands to commit adultery when they deny them of.
Okay,
so men are full of excuses. That's a woman responding now. Eh? Instead of accepting his fault. Eh? That was what the first man did in the Garden of Eden, of course, referring to Adam. Who blamed God for giving him Eve?
Well, God caught him with the apple.
Okay, that's all from the headlines this morning. Mm. And Mr. and Mrs., food for thought this morning.
And we'll keep Dr. Dan Ekere for the next discussion now as we get in. Let's take a breather and then we'll be back shortly. Stay with us now.